And their disgraces.
It was to get her attention, not because of COVID.
Oh, sorry. Didn't realise you were finished. You're not far away. They're tired because all this time they've been just one word in a stupid rhyme.
Divorce.
Beheaded.
Died.
Divorce.
Beheaded.
Survived.
Remember that from your GCSEs. You're about to learn a whole new meaning to it.
That's right, tonight we're going to take you on a little trip to find out who the Queens of Henry VIII really were.
Oh, me again? Really can't hear anything. Tonight is all about these ladies and their stories.
Wait a minute. I'm the king. Shouldn't this show be about me and not the people I was married to?
Exactly what I was thinking. I'm the most important person in history, unlike any of them.
All they did was marry me.
I think it should be about how amazing of a king I was.
Some of us didn't have a choice.
Shut up.
Hold on a second. I'm the king. Shouldn't I be the one making the rules around here?
Of course.
I know. What about all the battles we fought?
Yeah, we did win.
You mean the ones we helped you win?
Wait a minute. What would your show even be about anyway?
Yeah.
This.
Divorced.
Beheaded.
Died.
Divorced.
You're gonna find out how we got unfriended.
Tonight we're gonna do
overflow as we had the prefix. Everybody knows that we used to be six wise. Dancing to the beat till the break of day one. The clock will start again like it's the Renaissance. Everybody knows that we used to be six wise.
How about the winning contestant was the most protestant? Oh, come on, you guys, that was a good one.
We need you guys to decide which queen will take first place
before history is overthrown and one of our queens can take the spotlight.
Catherine, up first we have Catherine of Aragon. Take it away.
Now, just to give you some backstory, when I turned 16, I was shipped from Spain and introduced to a man called Arthur, the Prince of England. He then died, so naturally I was in prison for 17 years. But luckily for me, they decided I would marry Henry.
But wasn't he your dead husband's younger brother?
Yes.
And he was better looking as well, apparently.
Bit weird, but okay.
It did seem the summer of 09 though.
Anyway, 7 years later, and we're still trying for an heir because apparently daughters aren't good enough. Oh, hi, Mary.
Daughters are so easy to forget.
All of a sudden, Henry decides he wants our marriage annulled because he read a Bible verse that I'm cursed because I was his brother's wife. And now he wants to send me to a convent. Now that is where I draw the line, as I definitely would not look good in that wimple. So I'm like, no, no, no way.
It wasn't like that. I just fell for someone else.
You tried to replace me, now there's no way I'll grant you an annulment. And ask you what you think you've done wrong. We were married for 24 years and now you're running around with some pretty young thing. But I stuck by your side still. Okay, can I have my crown now because I'm obviously the winner?
We're nowhere near finished. We have to listen to everyone's story before we decide.
Our next queen is probably the most famous one of all. The one with the plan to steal the man.
So is Anne.
Wrong line!
Sorry, didn't know where we were up to. Next up is Anne Boleyn, the one who chased the king but paid the price, a swordsman to swing.
Wait a minute!
That isn't what happened.
Let me tell you how it really went down. I grew up in the French court, but life was a chore. So I set sail in 1522 and came to the UK. All I wanted to do was dance and sing because politics was not my thing. But then I met the king and my daddy said I should try and get ahead.
So she was the one that used me for all of my money and power.
No, you were the one who wouldn't stop writing to her until you got a reply.
And you were the one who moved home with your wife.
I really wish we could be closer so I could hear you guys. And you were the one that tried to elope, Pope said no, and set in motion the C of E.
But then things changed. Henry was all like,
"You damn witch, you've been flirting with the men."
And I was like, "So judgmental." But then he was like,
"Off with her head."
And I was like, "What was I meant to do?" Anyway, that was my time with him. Did I mention I was only 19?
Next up is the only queen that Henry truly loved.
Rude. She was one who finally gave him the son he really wanted.
And she was one who never stopped loving him no matter what he did.
Unlike all of you. That's true. All I did was love him with all of my heart. Even if I know who's only loving me because I gave him a son.
In his heart, he didn't love me. He loved the fact he could show to the world he had a perfect family. But as long as he was by my side, I didn't care. I was that in love with him.
Oh yeah, I knew you were my favourite for some reason.
Yes.
Rude. Sorry.
But my life wasn't that amazing either. I never got to see my son grow and one day become king. I never got to show him all the things a mother would teach her son.
Oh, are you done yet?
Yeah, and it was a bit tragic. It's not my fault though.
Who's next?
When everything is over and there is nothing left, you will find stone. My heart of stone. Because what hurts more than a broken heart?
A severed head.
Our next queen is Anne of Cleves. Her life was extremely different from that of the other queens. This is because Henry chose her off a portrait he saw of her, painted by Hans Holbein.
Welcome to the house!
To the house of Holbein, yeah! Oh yeah!
Beheaded. Been there, done that to a wife before. You're nothing special.
Hey.
Hey, it might have been done before, but my life was terrible as well, and wasn't just because of Henry. Because of how good looking I was. Every other man I met made my life terrible. They never really got to know me for me. All they knew is that I was pretty. I do feel the most sorry for Cleves though. I could never imagine getting rejected for my looks. It must have been so hard on you.
Yeah, yeah. People never saw the real you because of how you looked. Get on with it already.
My life was much more terrible than yours. I'm the only one who had real problems out of all of us. You were all manipulated by Henry. I was manipulated by every single man I met. And in my life of hell, in my short life, I got beheaded over a rumour. You lot couldn't possibly understand.
Your life really was tragic after all. I mean, not as bad as some of the others. Still.
So with our second and fifth wives beheaded, cousins by the way, that just leaves our lucky number six.
She was the one who survived, right? I mean, I know we thought some of the others didn't have hard lives, but come on. She survived. It must have been easy for her. Okay, I think this has gone on for long enough. It's time to pick a winner.
Everyone, just stop. I'm so done with this competition. It was such a bad idea to decide this way anyway. We are all strong, independent women, and we shouldn't be defining our lives by what some man did to us.
Some man. Some man? I'm the King of England, for goodness sake. The most important man in all of history.
You are only the most well-known because of us. You are known as the king who had six wives. Well, I'm sick of being the one who survived. Did you know what I did with my life before you? I was happy, truly happy. But me and Henry do have something in common. We both had our fair share of marriages, but I didn't behead any of mine. I know, right? Gold star for Kathy Parr. Then I met a man, this amazing, wonderful man, the love of my life, until you came along and ruined everything.
Well, I do feel sorry for you now. And you're right, this wasn't the way to do it.
Because you're all so much more than...
Divorced. Beheaded.
Died.
Divorced.
Beheaded.
Survived.
We're six!
Finish because you're that far away.
Don't blame us for social distancing.
They're tired because all this time there's been one word from some stupid rhyme.
Divorced.
Beheaded.
Died.
Divorced.
Beheaded.
Survived.
Remember that from your GCSEs? We're about to learn a whole new meaning to it.
That's right. Now we're going to take you on a little trip to see who the Queens of Henry VIII really were.
Psst. I couldn't hear you, all right. Tonight is all about their ladies and telling their stories.
Hold up a minute! I'm the king! Shouldn't the show be about me, not the people I was married to?
Exactly what I was thinking. I'm the most important one in history, not them.
All they did was marry me.
Shoo-shoo.
I think the story should be about me and what an amazing king I was.
Some of us didn't have a choice.
What can I say? I'm the king. I make the rules around here.
We could make it all about the great battles. I won, we won.
Do you mean the ones that we helped you win?
I'm sorry, but what would you show you can be about anyway?
This!
Divorced.
Beheaded.
So, are you going to decide?
Oh, I forget.
Who's the most power?
How about looks?
How much money you have?
I've got an idea. Who was married to me the longest?
Oh!
I've got it. What about had the worst time ever with him?
Okay, I'm first up, because obviously who lasted the longest was the strongest.
Or the biggest sinner, the obvious winner.
I think who has the sun should take number one.
Move change, I take first place.
It's definitely the most inglorious will be victorious.
How about the winning contestant is the most Protestant. Come on, guys, that was a good one.
We need you guys to help us decide which queen will take first place.
Before history is overthrown and one of our queens can take the spotlight.
Come on.
Sorry. You can't hear anything back there. Anyways, first up we have Catherine of Aragon. Take it away.
Now, just to give you some backstory, when I turned 16, I was shipped off from Spain and introduced to a man called Arthur. He was a Prince of England. He died.
Aww.
So naturally, I was in prison for 17 years. But luckily for me, they decided I would marry a man called Henry.
Ooh.
But wasn't he your dead husband's younger brother?
Yes.
Better looking as well, apparently.
A bit weird, but okay.
Oh, me again. Didn't you see him in the summer of 09, though?
Anyway, 7 years later, I was still trying for an heir, because apparently daughters aren't good enough. Oh, hi, Mary.
Daughters are so easy to forget.
Daughters are so easy to forget.
All of a sudden, he wants our marriage annulled because he read a Bible verse that I was cursed because I was his brother's wife and wants to send me to a convent. Now, that's where I draw the line because I know I definitely wouldn't look good in a wimple. So I'm like, no, wait.
Wasn't like that. Just fell for someone else.
You tried to replace me. Now, there's no way I'll grant you annulment. And ask you what I think I've done wrong. We've been married for 24 years and now you're running around with a pretty young thing. I stood by your side still.
So our next queen is probably the most famous of all. The one with the plan to steal the man.
So is Anne.
Wrong line!
Sorry, I don't know who we were up to. Next up is Anne Boleyn, the one who chased the king but had to pay the price of the sword and swing.
Wait a minute! That isn't what happened. Let me tell you how it went down. I grew up in the French court, but life was a chore, so I set sail in 1522 and came to the UK. All I wanted to do was dance and sing, as politics aren't my thing. But then I met the king, and my daddy said that I should try and get ahead.
See, she was the one who tried to use me to get my money and power.
You were the one who wouldn't stop writing to her until you got her a plan.
And you were the one who moved her in with your wife.
I wish we could be closer so I could hear you guys. Also, weren't you the one who tried to elope, but then the Pope said nope, and then you set a motion to the C of E?
But then things changed. Henry was like, you damn witch, you have been flirting with other men. And I'm like, so judgmental. And he's like,
off with her head.
And I'm like, well, what was I meant to do? Well, that was my time with him. Did I mention I was only 19?
Next up is the only queen who Henry truly loved.
Ruth!
She was the queen who finally gave Henry the son he wanted.
She was the one who never stopped loving him, no matter what he did.
Well, unlike all of you, that's true. For me, all I did was love him with all of my heart. Even if I knew he was only loving me because I gave him a son. In his heart, he didn't love me. He loved the fact that he could show the world that he had a perfect family. But as long as I was by his side, I didn't care. I was that in love with him.
I knew she was my favourite for a reason.
Rude!
And my heart wasn't that amazing either, as I never got to see my son grow up one day become king. I never got to teach him all the things a mother teaches her son.
So?
Okay.
Whatever.
Yeah, life was tragic.
But it wasn't because of me. Let's move on. Who's next?
When everything is over, when there is nothing left, you will still find stone. My heart stone. Because what hurts more than a broken heart?
A severed head! So our next queen is Anne of Cleves. Her life is extremely different from that of the other queens. This is because Henry chose her off a portrait painted by Hans Holbein.
Welcome to the house.
To the house of Holbein, yeah!
Till the day she died.
I know, right? How can anyone suffer a worse fate? Banished to a palace with more money than I could ever spend in a lifetime, and not a single man telling me what to do with it. How tragic is that? Just kidding, my life was eight.
Oh, that's a
good
one. Let me break it down for you. I got to do whatever I want, wear whatever I want, say whatever I want, go wherever I want, eat wherever I want, and there wasn't a man to boss me around with it. If I'm honest, my life was great.
Well, why do you deserve to be the lead singer then?
Well, I got rejected for my looks. Isn't that a bit of a downer on a girl's self-confidence?
True, but you were hardly beheaded now, were you?
She was my favourite.
I was tricked!
She looked nothing like her portrait, so obviously I needed another.
When Anne was summoned to England, she was extremely educated, but got rejected because of how she looked by the king.
Me again? She got sent to live in a palace in Richmond and was looked after financially till the day she died.
I know, right? How can anyone suffer a worse fate? Banished to a palace with more money than I could ever spend in a lifetime, and not a single man telling me what to do with it. How tragic is that? Just kidding, my life was eight. Oh, that's a good one there. Let me break it down for you. I got to do whatever I want, wear whatever I want, say whatever I want, go wherever I want, eat wherever I want, and there wasn't a man to boss me around with it. If I'm honest, my life was great.
Well, why do you deserve to be the lead singer then?
Well, I got rejected for my looks. Isn't that a bit of a downer on a girl's self-confidence?
True, but you were hardly beheaded now, were you?
She was my favourite.
Next up is the second queen that got beheaded.
I mean, her life wasn't really that tragic. I don't know how she'll compete with these other girls.
Are we on the forgettable Catherine now? All she did was get beheaded.
Been there, done that to her wife already. You're nothing special.
Hey, it might have been done before, but my life was terrible as well, and it wasn't just because of Henry.
Because of how good looking I was, every man I ever met was horrible to me, because they never got to know me for me. Aww. All they knew is that I was pretty.
Aww.
I do feel the most sorry for Cleves though. I could never imagine getting rejected because of my looks. It must have been so hard for you.
Yeah, people never saw the real you because of how you looked.
Get on with it already.
I was the only one who had real problems. I mean, you guys were just manipulated by Henry, but I was manipulated by every man in my life. And after a lifetime's worth of hell in my short life, I got beheaded over a rumour. And you lot couldn't possibly understand.
So with our second and fifth wife beheaded, who are cousins by the way, that only leaves us with our lucky number six.
She's the one who survived, right? I know we thought the others had a bad life, but come on, she survived. It must have been easy for her.
Everyone just stop. I'm so done with this competition. It was such a bad idea to decide this way. We are all strong and independent women. We shouldn't be defining our life by what some man did to us.
Yeah!
Some man. Do you know who you're talking about? I was the King of England, the most well-known in all of history.
You were only the most well-known because of us. You were known as the king who had six wives, but I'm sick of being the one who survived. Did you know what I did with my life before you? I was happy, truly happy. But me and Henry do have something in common. We both had our fair share of marriages, but I didn't behead any of mine. I know, gold star for Kathy Parr, am I right?
Yeah!
But then I met this man, this amazing, wonderful man. He was the love of my life, and Henry came along and ruined everything.
Boo!
Wow, I feel sorry for you now. And you're right, this isn't the way to do it.
Exactly. You are all one of a kind, no category. You should all stop living in his story.
We might need to keep apart, but it doesn't mean you can't take your crown and glory because you're six.
Yeah!
Look at us!
Sorry, boys, but from now on, it's all about girl power. Plus, you're so much more than six.